Hi, welcome to howtostats.com. In this video, I'm going to talk about outliers, and specifically, I'm going to talk about the quote-unquote right method of identifying an outlier in a distribution of data that are actually normally distributed. And I'll get to the issue of non-normal distributions later. But in data that roughly approximate a normal distribution, how can you go about detecting an outlier? I have another video talking about the two standard deviation away from the mean rule, and I demonstrated how invalid that rule was. But another rule that can be used is the outlier labeling rule. And that's what I'm going to talk about today, the outlier labeling rule, which you can, there are citations, and it works reasonably well. But the most frequently applied, the way that it's most frequently applied is not quite accurate, and I'll talk about that in a minute. The first way to go about examining for outliers is to actually look at the distribution. Unfortunately, in the utility that I'll be using in SPSS, you can get all the information you need at once. So let's look at this data set that I've created, and what I'm going to look at is this normal variable, and what I've done is I've created a distribution that is normally distributed with a program that can create distributions that are normally distributed. So I know this these data are normally distributed, and I also know that there aren't any outliers in it because the program was specified to generate data without outliers. So I'm going to look at this rule, the outlier labeling rule, to see how it works. So I go into Explore. I should probably talk about that first. Go into Analyze, Descriptives, and then go into Explore. All right, and then you've got your variable that you want to look at, and you put it in the dependent list. There's a couple of things that you are going to want in here. Go into Plots. I uncheck stem and leaf display. I'm not really interested in that, but I do want the histogram. Okay, and that's all you want in there. Click continue, then go to statistics, and unclick descriptives, click on percentiles and outliers. Those are the two things you need for this outlier labeling rule. Okay, and then you click OK. Alright, so the results are outputted, and let's just maximize the window. So the first table is telling me the sample size of 1,000, not very interesting. Percentiles, now this is the table that's going to give me the useful piece of information that I need to input into the formula. It's a very basic formula for the outlier labeling rule. But before I get to that, actually, I'm going to go to the histogram. This is the histogram of data. This is a normal distribution with a sample size of 1,000. All right, and there's a couple of observations over here on the right side of the tail that I suspect a lot of people would be looking at this and going, is that an outlier? These two might be outliers. And what about this observation over here? Is that an outlier? And because many parametric statistical analyses assume normal distributions, a lot of people might be inclined to get rid of these observations. But how do you determine whether you should or not? The two standard deviation rule that I discussed in another video is invalid. But the outlier labeling rule that I'll be demonstrating in this video is valid, but it can be used in an invalid way, and I'll get to that in a minute. So to use the outlier labeling rule, what you need as pieces of information is the 25th percentile value. So the 25th percentile corresponds to a value of 43.5. Okay, so in the distribution, 43.5, the mean or the median is 50, which is about here, and then the 25th percentile is about here. So that's the lower quartile, 43rd over here, and then the 75th percentile, the upper quartile, is 58.55, which is about 58.55 is about here. Okay, so 43 and 58 about here. And those are the two quartiles I'm particularly interested in for the purposes of calculating my upper bound and my lower bound for determining an outlier.